So now good afternoon. So today we will see what is the experiment. So today's experiment is a monostable and astable multivibrator. So we have two types of multivibrators. One is called as a monostable multivibrator and second one is called the astable multivibrator. So monostable, as the name suggests, it has got only one stable state. Okay, astable means there is no stable state. It is also called as a free-running multivibrator. Okay, so now today we will see how to design both monostable and astable multivibrator using 555 trial. Okay, so now I will start with the design of a monostable multivibrator. So for design, we require what is known as the duty cycle. So duty cycle is defined as T on divided by T on plus T off, and is expressed in terms of percentage. Okay, so for designing monostable multivibrator, we require this equation, that is called as a TDA. So TD is equal to 1.1 RA into C. It is a standard equation for calculating the time delay. So now here both this RA and RC are unknown. So therefore we are assuming C to be 0.1 microfarad, and TD, which is nothing, also called as T on, we are assuming from that we are calculating what is known as the RA. So RA is equal to TD by 1.1 times C. So this will become equal to RA equals 9.09 kilo ohms. So therefore we are choosing, so the standard resistance to be 10 kilo ohms. So this is the only design required for monostable multivibrator. So now let us come to the circuit diagram. So this is the standard 555 timer. Using the 555 timer, we are going to design this monostable multivibrator. It is an 8-pin IC. So let us see one by one. So what are the pin diagram of that one? So in this 555 timer, so 4 and 8 are shorted, and we are giving it to plus 5 volts. And pin number 7, pin number 6, so they are shorted here and is connected to RA. And pin number 3 is always output pin. Okay, so from there we are taking the capacitor C, so it is equal to 0.1 microfarad. So where we have assumed here, so it is 0.1. So these two values RA and C are responsible for generating the output of a motor shot. Okay, so now here when we come to this point, we are using a diode. So IM004007, it is connected to pin number 2. So and then the 10 kilo ohms, it is connected to pin number 4 and 8. And we are giving a trigger. So this is called as trigger pulse. So this is a trigger pulse. So we are generating from the function generator. So that trigger pulse is of 1 kilohertz and 1 volts. So that is given to pin number 2. If you see the diagram of 555 timer, this pin number 2 is called the trigger point. Okay, so pin number 3 is called as the output point, pin number 1 is ground, pin number 4 and 8 are called as the VCC points. Okay, so pin number 7 is called as the threshold, and pin number 6 is called as the control voltage point. So these points are there in the theory class we have explained to you. So we are using those points for generating the monoshot parts. Okay, so this is a standard circuit for generating a pulse from a 555 timer. So since it is a mono pulse, so once we apply the trigger pulse, we get one pulse like this. We get a one pulse like this. So this is what we get as the output. This is called as mono shot. It has got only one stable state, one on state, okay, one off state. So that is what the monostable multivibrator is. Okay. So now coming to the astable multivibrator. So we have got the second experiment, that is astable multivibrator. So this is also designed using 555 timer. As the name only suggests, astable means there is no stable state and it is a free running multivibrator. The difference between the monoshot and astable is, so in the monostable multivibrator, we require a trigger input. We require a trigger input. Whereas in the case of astable, there is no trigger point. We don't require operator. So if you simply give BCC, it starts giving the pulses. It is in the form of a square. It is a square pulse. Okay. So first we start with the design. So we have assumed that duty cycle D to be 75%. So duty cycle means it is T on and T off. So here we have assumed T on, so to be 0.75 milliseconds, and T off, so to be 0.25. Okay. So if I add this one, 0.75 plus 0.25, I'll get the total time is equal to 1 millisecond. Okay. So now here how to calculate the T on is given by this equation. So T on is equal to 0.693 times RA plus RB into C. This is the standard equation for calculating the on time period for a stable multiplier. So now we have to assume one of the value and calculate the other. So therefore I take this T of equation, because here we have three unknowns. RA, RB and C are three unknowns. Therefore I cannot calculate. So therefore I go to T of formula. So here T of is equal to 0.693 times RB into C. So now here RB and C are the variables. T of anyhow we have assumed it to be 0.25 milliseconds. So using that I calculate what is the value of RB. So here I have calculated RB. So RB is equal to T of divided by 0.693 into C. So if you substitute here, so it is RT of is 0.25 milliseconds. It is 0.25 millisecond divided by 0.693 into 1 microfarad. So now if I calculate, RB comes up to be 3.6 kilohms. So therefore, we are assuming the standard resistance to be 3.3 kilohms. So now I use this RB value in this equation, in the T on equation. So therefore, the value for RA becomes T on divided by 0.693 into C minus RB. Okay, I have used this equation and I have simplified. So we have got RA to this equation. So now I substitute T on to be 0.75 milliseconds. So C to B, it is equal to 0.1 microfarad, and RB, it is 3.3 kilohms. If I substitute, so I get RA, it is 7.5 kilohms. Now since 7.5 kilohms is not a standard resistance, so therefore we are using DRB to set 7.5 kilohms. So this is the standard design for an A-stable multiplier. So now if I change the duty cycle, accordingly T on and T off will change. So then this value RA and RB is going to change. So now here the value of RA and RB depends on the duty cycle of the A-stable multiplier. So now let us come to the circuit diagram. So now here the same thing. So pin number 4 and pin number 8 is all the VCC points. So therefore I have shorted these two and connected to VCC. So this is equal to 5 ohms. So we always use 5 ohms. So now from this VCC point, so I have connected RA. It is equal to 7.5 kilohms. So from pin number 7, I have directly connected one end of RA. So pin number 6 and pin number 2 are shorted and it is connected to another end of RB, and from that point so I have connected, so one capacitor 0.1 microfarad and second capacitor 0.2 microfarad. Okay, so from pin number 5 and pin number 1 it is always grounded here, and from pin number 6 we take the output. Okay, so for a stable multiplier, we, as I said, it is a free running, so we get a pulse like this. It is a stream of pulses. So this is what we get. For a mono shot, we get only one pulse, whereas for a stable, we get a stream of pulses. And this, if you measure the time period T, it should be equal to 1 millisecond according to our design. So 1 millisecond, if you convert into frequency, so this will be 1 over 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3, it comes out to be 1 kilohertz. So this is how we can get the output from the 555 timer. So this is one of the applications of 555 timer. So 555 timer is used to generate either a trigger pulse output or a free running this is about the design of the two experiments. So now I am going to give you the live demo of the experiment. So I will connect both the Astable and Monostable.